name is Srishti Agarwal, EPS third year. Today I am going to perform the experiment characteristics of optocoupler. What is optocoupler? Optocoupler is an optoisolator. It is an electronic device which isolates the two electric circuits, and it uses light to transfer electrical signals from one circuit to the other circuit. So the main working principle of the optocoupler is that in the first circuit, any light emitting diode is connected, which turns on when the current flows in the first circuit, and a phototransistor which is connected in the other circuit, it senses the light and turns on the current flowing in the second circuit. So there are many applications and advantages of the optocoupler. Like when there is a high voltage or a high strike in one circuit, it does not harm the second circuit. And it can be used in many applications, like switching power supply, motor control, audio equipments or communication equipments. Now I will tell that how we can make a simple optocoupler using a breadboard and a optocoupler IC. So to make a simple optocoupler, we need optocoupler IC, breadboard, IR LED, photo transistor, connectors and some resistors. So there are some specifications of the LED and the photo transistor, like what is the maximum current it can pass through. So we need to calculate some resistance which we can add in the first circuit and the second circuit to not exceed the limits of the specification given in our lab manual. To select appropriate resistor values for the optocoupler circuit, we need some specifications of both IR LED and phototransistor. For IR LED, the maximum forward voltage forward current is 20 milliampere and 1.7 volt, which means that we need to limit the current through the LED to 20 milliampere or less. To calculate the value of the resistor R1 required to achieve this current, we can find the R1 using the Ohm's law, that R is equals to difference in the supplied voltage and the maximum voltage of LED to the maximum current. So by the calculations, it comes out to be near 180 ohm. So we can connect 180 ohm to our first circuit. For the phototransistor, the maximum collector emitter voltage VCO is given as 30 volt. So to find out the resistor we need to add in the second circuit, we will again use the Ohm's law, and we are assuming that the power supply is the basic 5 volt power supply. So we will find the resistance by using Vout by Iout. So Vout in the circuit is the 5 volt minus the minus 1.7 volt which is given in the LED, divided by the maximum current which is 1 milliampere. So by this standard resistor which we can add in the second circuit comes to near 5.1 kilo ohms. Send the trainer kit which is given in an experiment. First there is an optocoupler, there are two isolated circuits, and then there is a wave shaper and there is a counter. So wave shaper is used to make the raw output of the optocoupler to an form which can be easily analyzed, and this there is a counter which counts the number of events or the trigger happens in the optocoupler output, and it is connected to a display which increases the count. So in this kit the LED is IR LED. So if we pass this paper in the circuit, then there is no change in the count, because this paper is very thin and it can pass IR radiations through it. So we need to fold this paper, and then if we pass this this in the optocoupler, then there is a red light there, but the count is not increased, which means that the count will be increased in the rising edge of the output, and then I will remove it, then it will increase the count. It means that it increased the count in the rising edge of the output.
In our trainer kit, we uses IR LED instead of visible LED, because there are many advantages of IR LED over visible LED. First of all, IR LEDs have high sensitivity to changes in the ambient light and can detect weaker signals. Second, IR light has lower noise compared to the visible region. Third, it can transmit over long distances compared to the visible light. And fourth is that it has less interference. IR interacts lesser to other light sources or any other EM waves compared to the visible lights. And also that IR radiations have better isolations. If it passes through the any medium, air or any medium, then it have very it interacts with other EM waves very less. And other that IR waves have long lesser penetration properties, that it cannot penetrate in at any from any devices. Like we see, like we have seen that it penetrates through the paper of this length, but it cannot penetrate through the paper of the double width. Now coming to an innovative idea or some good applications of optocoupler. One of the best application of optocoupler is in digital communication circuits. In these circuits, as optocoupler is used to transmit digital signals between two circuits without any electrical connections. So the optocoupler is connected such that the digital signal is applied to the LED, which emits light that is detected by photodiode in the output circuit. This allows the digital signal to be transmitted without any direct electrical connection between input and output circuit, providing a safe and reliable means of communication. For example, consider a circuit that transmits digital signals between two computer systems. Without an optocoupler, direct connection between the computer system could result in electrical interference and damage to the computer hardware. By using the optocoupler, the digital signals can be safely transmitted without any harm or damage to the computer signals. So this is the main advantage of the optocoupler, and it can also be used in motor circuits or any audio circuit.